Hey everyone, welcome back to Spunt. Today we're diving into a topic that's been making waves in the tech world. Use export controls on high-performance computing gear and how they're impacting the race for technological supremacy between the US and China. Now, you might have heard about the back and forth between these two powerhouses, especially when it comes to advanced chips and supercomputing. But what does it all mean? How effective are these controls, really? And what's the latest with companies like Nvidia and Huawei in this ongoing battle? Stick around, because we're going to unpack all of that and more. When it comes to controlling the spread of advanced technology, particularly high-performance computing HPC engines, the United States has found itself in a tricky situation. Over the years, the US has repeatedly tried to impose export controls to slow down China's ability to build supercomputers capable of running advanced simulations and AI workloads. But here's the kicker. It's often too little, too late. By the time these controls are put in place, China has already made significant strides, and the intended long-term effects on their technological capabilities are marginal at best. Let's be real. If the goal is just to slow China down, then yes, these export controls could be considered somewhat successful. But in the grand scheme of things, they don't do much more than that. What happens instead is that US companies like Intel and Nvidia end up losing out on revenue because they're restricted from selling to a massive market. Plus, we lose visibility into what's actually happening in China's supercomputing centers. All of this just to delay China's progress by a couple of years while causing some headaches for Chinese HPC centers, hyperscalers, and cloud builders. Take Huawei, for example. Despite US sanctions that have cut them off from some of the most advanced chips, they're on the brink of launching a new AI-focused processor, the Ascend 910C. According to reports, this chip is currently being tested by major Chinese internet and telecom companies and could give Nvidia's H100 a run for its money. Huawei is telling potential customers that the 910C is comparable to the H100, which is pretty significant given that Nvidia's chips are among the most powerful in the world. Although Huawei didn't respond to requests for comment, it's clear that they're moving full steam ahead despite the sanctions. Now, this isn't the first time we've seen this export control game play out. Remember back in October 2010? That's when China's Tianhe won a supercomputer built by the National University of Defense Technology, was unveiled as the fastest in the world. It was packed with 14,336 Intel Xeon processors and 7,160 Wright NVIDIA Tesla M250 GPUs, delivering a jaw-dropping 4.7 petaflops of peak performance. The US was concerned, but by the time they realized what was happening, it was already too late. Fast forward a few years, and the Tianhe 2 machine in Guangzhou was even more powerful, using 16,000 Intel Xeon E5 processors and 16,000 Knights Corner Xeon Phi accelerators. When China planned to upgrade this machine to the Tianhe 2A using the even more powerful Knights landing chips from Intel, the US government stepped in. The Department of Commerce blocked Intel from selling these chips to certain Chinese HPC centers, hoping to curb China's progress. But did it work? Not really. China simply developed its own accelerators. The Matrix 2000, believed to be based on RM cores with powerful vector engines. The result? Tianhe 2A achieved a peak performance of just under 95 petaflops at FP64 precision. And US export controls ended up pushing China to innovate even faster. The story is similar with the latest round of export controls on Nvidia, AMD, and Intel accelerators for HPC and AI workloads. Rather than stopping China in its tracks, these restrictions are likely to accelerate China's efforts to develop indigenous technology. And that's exactly what we're seeing with Huawei's upcoming Ascend 910C chip. To give you a clearer picture, let's look at how Nvidia has navigated these restrictions. When the US first imposed sanctions, Nvidia responded by creating modified versions of their chips for the Chinese market, like the A800 and H800. The A800, for example, had its GPU memory capacity halved and memory bandwidth reduced by 25%. Nvidia also switched to a PCI Express 4.0 form factor, limiting shared memory to 2 GPUs over NVLink, compared to the 8 GPUs supported by the full-fledged A100. The result was a chip that was still powerful, but significantly hampered compared to its original version. With the H800, Nvidia went even further, capping the GPU's performance and reducing memory bandwidth by 39%. The US government decided this wasn't enough and tightened restrictions further, capping the compute power even more. Despite these limitations, Nvidia continues to produce these crimped versions for the Chinese market. But it's clear that these products are a far cry from what's available elsewhere. As for Huawei, they're not sitting idly by. Their new Ascend 910C chip, which is expected to start shipping as soon as October, is already generating buzz among major Chinese tech companies like ByteDance, Baidu, and China Mobile. Early negotiations suggest that orders for the 910C could surpass 70,000 chips, potentially bringing in around $2 billion for Huawei. This is no small feat, especially in the face of US sanctions designed to stifle their technological progress. So, what's the takeaway here? US export controls might slow China down temporarily, but they're also driving innovation within China, pushing companies like Huawei to develop their own advanced technology. And as China continues to make strides in HPC and AI, it's becoming increasingly clear that these controls are doing little to halt the long-term progress that the US was hoping to stop. And there you have it, folks. A deep dive into the ongoing battle over high-performance computing and AI between the US and China. It's a complex and rapidly evolving situation, with major implications for the future of technology. What do you think about these export controls? Are they effective? Or are they just pushing China to innovate faster? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. And if you found this video informative, don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe to Spunt, and ring the bell for more in-depth analysis on the latest tech news. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.